Hello friends, today in this series, these are the lectures on the ancient history by the Brainy IAS, and this is the second lecture in this series. In the earlier lecture, we have seen about the concept of history, ancient history, medieval history and modern history. After that, we have also seen the syllabus of UPSC. Now we are into this, we have discussed what is the history, Paleolithic age, Mesolithic age, Neolithic age, Chalcolithic age and Megalithic age. Whereas we have also discussed Stone Age as well as Metal Age. We have divided history in the earlier lectures. Now we are coming to the second part of this lecture series. The second part is of Indus Valley Civilization. As you have seen earlier in the earlier lectures that the human beings were totally nomads. Nomads mean they were wanderers, they were moving from one place to another in search of food. And when they were searching, they were wandering in search of food from one place to another, at that point of time, they had no proper or you can say permanent settlement. But slowly and steadily, as the ice age started melting, or you can say the ice or the glaciers started melting, the people started to live on the banks of the rivers which started flowing during that time. Now, dear friends, what happened was, it was not the Indian society or Indian part which was having, you can say the settlement. Along the rivers of the world, other major civilizations also flourished. The other major civilizations which flourished during this phase were like, one civilization which flourished was Nile, the Egyptian civilization on the banks of River Nile. The another civilization was on the banks of river in Iraq, on the banks of river Tigris and Euphrates. In do nadiyon ke kinare ek civilization aur panpi thi, and the name of the civilization was Mesopotamian civilization. Apart from the Mesopotamian civilization and this Egyptian civilization, we had one more civilization. The name of the another civilization was Huanghu civilization, on the banks of river Huanghu. And the last civilization which flourished, the major civilization which flourished during this phase was Indus Valley civilization. This Indus Valley civilization, friends, was contemporary to all these civilizations. And all these civilizations has contributed some kind of, you can say, achievement, or they have contributed something to the society. For example, Chinese civilization has contributed a lot more things like mariner compass and all. Whereas the Egyptian civilization gave us the idea about how to develop pyramids and these mathematical structures. Whereas Indus Valley civilization is that part of the history in which we can say that Indus Valley civilization also contributed, or in this civilization also contributed the new way of life, that is the urban way of life, to the society. It was considered to be the first urban society of this world. Now, about Indus Valley civilization, how we will be covering this topic, class? We will be covering, first of all, we will be taking the discovery of Indus Valley civilization, who discovered it and how it was discovered. Second thing we'll be taking will be the chronology of Indus Valley civilization. Third thing we'll be discussing will be the extent of Indus Valley civilization, extent of IVC, Indus Valley civilization. Fourth will be the features. In features, we will be discussing the general features of Indus Valley civilization. General features of Indus Valley civilization. Apart from it, we will be discussing economic aspects. In economic aspects, we will be discussing where these people dwelt, or where these people tried to settle down. After that, we will be discussing social, political and cultural part of Indus Valley civilization, in which we will be discussing religion, we will be discussing script, and we will be discussing art and architecture of Indus Valley civilization. Now, after this, whensoever we will be discussing this, after that we will be discussing the rise and decline of Indus Valley civilization. Rise and decline of IVC. And after rise and decline of IVC, we will be discussing the cause of decline. Cause of decline. Plus, as you yourself know, or as we have discussed in the previous lecture, that the Indus Valley civilization belonged to that phase in which the writing was known. It was a literate society, or we can also say that it was first urban and literate society. By the term urban, I mean that its setup was an urban setup, where everything was planned in a manner. Whereas if I say that it was literate society, by the term literate society, it is meant that this civilization was the civilization who knew the art of writing. But irony is that they wrote something, and whatsoever they have written it, we are not able to understand in today's scenario. We are not able to decipher that part in today's scenario. Now, if we are not able to decipher it, friends, then we can consider that this IVC belonged to one thing, that is proto-historic phase. IVC belonged to proto-historic phase. Proto-historic, friends, is that phase of history in which you can say that they have written something, but you're not able to decipher in today's context. So they have written something in their own language, but we are not able to understand that in today's scenario. So that part is coming under this. And if I have to put it in another category, then I can put it that the Indus Valley civilization was from Chalcolithic age. Chalcolithic age. Now, what is this Chalcolithic age? Chalcolithic age, friends, is an age in which the tools, implements, and everything over there, they were built or they were made out of copper. So, proto-historic phase and Chalcolithic age, in which they knew the art of metallurgy, one thing, and we have seen that they had bronze, and bronze is an alloy of copper and tin. Hence, we can consider that they are the part of the Chalcolithic phase. So, class, after this, then what we can say about Indus Valley civilization? Indus Valley civilization, friends, is discovered from, there are two sites in this, that is the Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. The Harappa site was discovered in the year 1920 and 1921 by Dayaram Sahni, whereas the Mohenjo-daro site was discovered by R.D. Banerjee. This is the main point that has to be remembered. And this Harappa is a type site, and it is on the banks of River Ravi. Now, what is this, friends, type site? Whatsoever site which has been discovered at the first instance, we call it as a type site. And the name, this name of this type site is given to entire excavation. So, Indus Valley civilization can also be called, or you can find its reference as Harappan civilization in other books also. Okay, now after this, what is the next point? We have Mohenjo-daro, we have Harappa. Harappa was discovered by Dayaram Sahni on the banks of river, whereas Mohenjo-daro was discovered by R.D. Banerjee. Now, coming to the extent of Indus Valley civilization, in India, if I talk about the Indus Valley civilization, its extent is in the north, it is in J&K. From J&K, we move downward, then it is in Punjab, Haryana, Western UP, then we move to the Gujarat. And apart from it, if you look at it, the river Indus, which flows from Jammu and Kashmir, on the banks of that river, we have Indus Valley civilization. This river moves to the Pakistan, so some of its locations are there in the Pakistan also. The few states in which the Indus Valley excavations have been done in Pakistan, those are Punjab, Baluchistan and Sindh. In teen jagahon pe Indus Valley civilization ke hame avshesh mile hain. Ab class iske baad dusra aspect, theek hai. First thing is, we have got Indus Valley civilization excavations on we have excavated this Indus Valley civilization on the banks of river Indus. Second thing which has to be kept in mind, that this was not the civilization which had only one kind of geographical feature or economical aspect. In this Indus Valley civilization, they had different aspects or different relief features. For example, this Indus Valley civilization was there in Baluchistan, which is not a plain area. Okay, so they had hill terrains over there. In India also, if we look into it, they have hill terrains where it is found. Apart from it, we have plains, where this Indus Valley civilization or Indus Valley people flourished. After this, plain, it is deserts. In India, in deserts in Rajasthan, we have found some excavations. We have done some excavations. Then from there, if we move to Gujarat, Kutch region, then in Kutch region also, we find some of the sites of Indus Valley civilization, like the areas of Dhaulavira and all. So we have a mixture kind of a thing in this Indus Valley civilization, and it is not very much, you can say, prominent to one particular location that, okay, this civilization flourished only in the Gangetic Plain. No, this civilization flourished on the hill range, on the hills. This civilization was there in the deserts. This civilization was there in the swamps. This civilization was there even in the fertile plains. So there was a structure in it, or you can say there were, the people were surviving on one end, the people were in the hilly regions. On the other end, the people were in the deserts. So we had two different kind of, or you can say many kind of terrains on which Indus Valley civilization flourished. Now coming to another aspect there, as I told you earlier, it is the first urban civilization of this planet. Now if I am talking about this first urban civilization, it means that everything over there in the Indus Valley civilization, the most common thing was every city was divided into two parts. Divided into two parts means one part was at the higher end, another part was at the lower end. This structure is almost common in all the sites except few sites. Now the structure which is at the high point and the structure which is low point, the structure at the high point is known as a citadel, whereas structure at the lower part is known as the common houses. On the citadels, the thing that was very much prominent over here was all the important functions of Indus Valley civilization used to take place on those citadels, whereas all the other parts or the living places of the people used to be there in the lower part. Moreover, one more thing which has to be taken into consideration was is it was such an urban state. Urban state means it was ek shahri shahar tha ye. But itna bada shahar basane ke liye aapke paas agriculture hona bahut zaruri hai. You have to be you need to have a large agricultural base in order to sustain the development of such kind. But unfortunately, according to excavations, we are not able to find anything related to the agriculture which could prove that it could sustain such a big settlement. Though we have found some things which are in support of this thing, like we in Kalibanga, Rajasthan, we found plowed field. Kalibanga, Rajasthan, plowed field. हमें एक प्लोट फील्ड मिली रहा है वहां पे. अपार्ट फ्रॉम इट, इन बनवाली हरियाणा, वी गॉट टेराकोटा रेप्लिका ऑफ प्लो. थर्ड थिंग, वी फाउंड राइस इन लोथल एंड भगतराव एज वेल एज धौलावीरा. तो इन तीन जगहों पे अगर हम देखें तो हमें कुछ कुछ चीजें मिली जहां पे एग्रीकल्चरल चीजें हैं, एंड वी केम टू नो दैट ओके एग्रीकल्चर वॉज देयर, बट एग्रीकल्चरल सरप्लस दैट कैन नॉट बी इग्नोर्ड और दैट कैन नॉट बी इवन एक्सेप्टेड. In case of Indus Valley civilization, why we are that much, you can say, we have narrow knowledge, because we have only archaeological remains. Hamare paas sirf aur sirf archaeological remains hai. We do not have any kind of literary remains. Literary remains matlab jahan pe ye koi hame koi kitab mile ya fir hame koi aisi cheez mile jiske upar jisko padh ke we can direct ki okay theek hai yahan pe ye cheez ye kara kiya karte the. That we will see in the later classes, that Rigvedic age mein we will see that there is Rigved, Samved, Atharved, Yajurved and Samved. So in Vedo mein likha gaya hai ki what these people used to do. So we can predict about that society. But in case of Indus Valley civilization, we are not able to do so. Why we are not able to do so? Because we don't have any literary source, because it belongs to the proto-historic phase. So whatsoever thing we got over there, we are just putting our माइंड प्रोसेस कि लोग ऐसा करते होंगे. वी आर नॉट श्योर दैट दे वर डूइंग इट और दे वर नॉट डूइंग इट. सो ऑल इन ऑल इट इज समथिंग लाइक दिस कि वो करते होंगे. अपार्ट फ्रॉम एट क्लास, हमें और भी चीजें मिली है, हमें कुछ क्रॉप्स मिली है इनकी. द क्रॉप्स वर लाइक व्हीट, क्रॉप्स वर वीट, बार्ले, डेट एंड मस्टर्ड. वीट, बार्ले, डेट एंड मस्टर्ड. हमें ये क्रॉप्स भी इनसे मिली हैं. इन क्रॉप्स के मिलने का मतलब क्या था कि ये एग्रीकल्चर तो करते थे. ठीक है, सो वी हैव डिस्कस क्लास जनरल फीचर. ऑन इकोनॉमिक एस्पेक्ट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट ओके, इकोनॉमिकली दे वर वेरी गुड, दे हैड अ वेरी वास्ट टेरेन. थर्ड थिंग, दे हैड एग्रीकल्चर ऑल्सो. एग्रीकल्चर, एग्रीकल्चर में भी उन्होंने क्या क्या चीजें देखी थी, वी हैव सीन दैट. एंड वी हैव सीन एग्रीकल्चर रिमेन्स में हमें क्या क्या मिला. हमें प्लॉट फील्ड मिली. प्लॉट फील्ड मतलब जहां पे एक पूरे के पूरा हल जोता हुआ एक फील्ड में मिला हुआ है. वी हैव एक्सकवेटेड इट. सो वी केम टू द कंक्लूजन कि ये एग्रीकल्चर भी करते थे. इसके बाद नेक्स्ट पॉइंट कि इनके पास क्राफ्ट्स की बात करते हैं हम. अगर मैं इनके क्राफ्ट्स की बात करता हूं क्लास फ्रेंड्स, देन वी हैव पॉटरी, ब्रिक्स, टेराकोटा एंड स्टोन. इन चीजों के ऊपर हम बात करते हैं. सो इफ आई टॉक अबाउट क्राफ्ट इन दिस ऑफ इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन, सो क्राफ्ट आई कैन क्लासीफाई इट इन टू द फर्स्ट विल बी पॉटरी. पॉटरी सेकेंड विल बी ब्रिक्स. ब्रिक्स थर्ड विल बी टेराकोटा. फोर्थ विल बी स्टोन. अब सबसे पहले मैं बात करता हूं पॉटरी की. पॉटरी में हमें जो इनसे चीज मिली है दैट इज बी आर डब्ल्यू, ब्लैक रेड वेयर. दिस इज अ काइंड ऑफ अ पॉटरी. एक पीछे बैकग्राउंड किसी और चीज का होगा, आगे कलर किसी और चीज का होगा. सो इट इज बी आर डब्ल्यू पॉटरी. ब्रिक्स की अगर मैं बात करता हूं, वेरी यूनिक एंड वेरी स्ट्राइकिंग एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर अबाउट द ब्रिक्स इज दो सिविलाइजेशन फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान टू महाराष्ट्र ऑन द बॉर्डर्स ऑफ इट. ये इतनी दूर दूर तक फैली हुई थी सिविलाइजेशन, येट ब्रिक्स जो इनकी हमें मिली है वो हमें सिर्फ दो टाइप्स की मिली है. इधर देवर फायर बेक्ड, फायर बेक्ड और सन ड्राइड. या फिर वो फायर बेक्ड थी या फिर वो सन ड्राइड थी. फायर बेक्ड एंड सन ड्राइड मतलब ये दो ही टेक्निक से इनके अंडर थी जिनको ये मास्टर कर चुके थे उस टाइम पे. नाउ अबाउट फायर बेक्ड एंड इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ द ब्रिक्स इज ऑल द बिल्डिंग मटीरियल दैट वी गॉट फॉर दिस फ्रॉम दिस सिविलाइजेशंस. वी फाउंड वन थिंग दैट इज दिस सिविलाइजेशन वॉज हैविंग यूनिफॉर्म साइज ऑफ ब्रिक्स. Uniform size of bricks. Why I am emphasizing on it that they had a uniform size of bricks. This leads us to one more conclusion, that is all the people in the Indus Valley civilization, they were some kind of connected or administered centrally. इनको कहीं ना कहीं centrally administer किया जाता होगा, तभी ऐसा हो सकता है कि सारी के सारी bricks का एक ही size हो. So this is the important part that is of bricks. Next is terracotta. टेराकोटा की अगर मैं बात करता हूं इन दिस, देन दे वी हैव फिग्रींस ऑफ मदर गॉडेस दैट वी फाउंड. सो हमें मदर गॉडेस की फिग्रींस मिली है टेराकोटा की बनी हुई. सो वी हैड पॉटरी ऑल्सो वेरी गुड, ब्रिक्स, अ सेंट्रली एडमिनिस्टर्ड एरिया, टेराकोटा, स्टोन. इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द स्टोन्स, देन वी गॉट टू मेल टॉर्सोस. टॉर्सोस, सी दे आर टू थिंग्स, वन इज द टॉर्सो, वन इज द बस्ट. If I talk about the bust, bust is something which is a body structure without hands. Whereas torso is something with a body structure, upper part without head. So we even got some of the torsos which were built out of stones. And moreover, if I talk about the seals also, then seals ke andar bhi humare paas ek inka structure milta hai crafts ka. In the seals ke andar. Metal crafts. अपार्ट फ्रॉम स्टोन वी हैव मेटल्स. मेटल क्राफ्ट भी हमारे पास है. अब इस मेटल क्राफ्ट के अंदर क्या आएगा, इस मेटल क्राफ्ट के अंदर वी हैव ब्रोंज डांसिंग गर्ल. मतलब दीज पीपल वर वेरी गुड एट आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट. पॉटरी, ब्रिक्स, टेराकोटा, स्टोन, मेटल. मेटल के लिए अंदर हमारा आ जाएगा डांसिंग गर्ल. डांसिंग गर्ल हमें एक फिगरीन मिली है इसके डांसिंग गर्ल की. एंड वन मोर वेरी स्ट्राइकिंग फीचर ऑफ दिस इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन इज शेल क्राफ्ट. शेल क्राफ्ट This shell craft, we found it from Chunhadar, Chunhadar, and Balakot areas. Shellcraft matlab, ye jo sea shells hote hain unke upar. So, they were having shellcrafts, they were having metals. In metals also, we have bronze as well as we have gold also. They used to wear the ornaments of gold and silver. Wo gold and silver ke ornaments pehnte the. We had terracotta, we have bricks, we have pottery. So these are the few important things that are to be taken care of. Apart from it, class, Indus seals ki agar main baat karta hoon, to Indus seals were the seals which were, you can say, hame mili thi. Dekho, Indus seals, Indus Valley civilization people, they had a trade relationships with other countries like Mesopotamia, and Mesopotamia is modern Iraq. Inka trade relationship tha in logon ke saath. Ab inki trade ki agar main baat karta, if I have taken the topic of trade, then if I talk about this trade, friends, then in trade, they used to trade with the people of other countries. Other countries ka matlab ye hai, ye inki hume seals mili hai at the locations of Mesopotamia. Moreover, we also got some kind of precious stones. और वो precious stones like lapis lazuli, ये precious stones जो थे ये यहाँ पे नहीं मिलते इंडिया में. ये precious stones हमें मिलते हैं somewhere in Afghanistan. और हमें ये अफगानिस्तान में मिले हैं, इसका मतलब ये है कि they had some kind of trading with Afghanistan and further to the west. तो यहाँ पे हमें सारी की सारी चीजें हमें वेस्ट में जाके इनका ट्रेड का पता चलता है. उसके बाद अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस ट्रेड, वी फाइंड वन मोर थिंग दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन इज नॉट, यू कैन से डिसाइफर्ड, द टेक्स्ट ऑफ इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन इज नॉट डिसाइफर्ड, बट एट द सेम टाइम द टेक्स्ट ऑफ सम कंटेम्प्रेरी सिविलाइजेशंस लाइक मेसोपोटामियन सिविलाइजेशन आर डिसाइफर्ड. और वो हमसे, हमने उनको डिसाइफर कर दिया है, तो वहां पर हमें एक चीज मिली है. क्या? They have mentioned about few places which lie to their east. Or unme worth mentioning is one place that they talked about, and that is the Melhua. Now this name suggests that this Melhua is a place somewhere in the east, and the name of the place will be IVC. Matlab, when this civilization was in the proto-historic phase, friends, at that point of time, the Indus Valley civilization, Mesopotamian civilization was in the historic phase, because we are able to decipher it. So Melhua is a place they have mentioned, and according to historians, it is Indus Valley civilization. On the another aspect, they have also mentioned one more place, that is Dilmen, and this place is Bahrain. Ye jo place hai, isko hum kehte hain Bahrain. And one more site they have mentioned is the Makar, but that is a coastal part. So we are only concerned about these two things. One is the Melhua. They have some kind of trade relationships with India. Indian seals hame wahan pe mili hai, India, but Indus Valley civilization. Indus Valley civilization ki hame kuch seals wahan pe mili hai, aur unki seals hame yahan pe mili hai. We have found seals of Mesopotamia and Gulf Persian countries. Persian countries ki jo aapki Gulf ki jo seals hain, those seals are cylindrical in nature. Cylindrical matlab wo gol hai, cylinder ki tarah hai. So this is a distinction that can be asked. So these are the few aspects of Indus Valley civilization crafts and their establishment. Third topic related to this, under this, is their way of life or literature. Now, under way of life and literature, the first thing that has to be taken care of is they used to worship, and they worship one thing, that is people. People ka hame pata hai, they worshipped. And in case of animals, three animals are to be remembered. One is the unicorn, second one is the humped bull, and third one is the snake. Ye teen cheezon ki ye log puja kiya karte the. If you look into the other books, NCRTs, then you will come across this thing that they even worshipped Pashupati. Now Pashupati is something which is, according to historians, is Lord Shiva. So we can consider, or this point can never be negated, that they were the worshippers of Lord Shiva. Why? Because we found an image of an individual who is sitting in the yoga position, and that he's wearing some kind of crown with some moon-like structure on his head. So we say this is Pashupati. And second thing that we found was the dancing, और एक नटराजन जिसको हम कहते हैं कि तांडव करता हुआ हमें एक वहाँ पे एक स्ट्रक्चर मिला है, और जो तांडव करता हुआ स्ट्रक्चर हमें मिला है दैट स्ट्रक्चर इज नोन एज शिवा, कि शिवा वहाँ पे तांडव कर रहे हैं. सो दिस पॉइंट कैन नेवर बी नेगेटेड दैट वी डिड नॉट फाइंड एनी काइंड ऑफ शिवा स्ट्रक्चर, और दे वर नॉट द वर्शिपर्स ऑफ लॉर्ड शिवा, और दिस कैन नेवर बी एक्सेप्टेड ऑल्सो एज वी हैव नो लिटरेरी सोर्सेज. बट इफ वी लुक टू द थ्रू द प्रिज्म ऑफ टूडेज सीनियर यू विल से यस दे वर द वर्शिपर्स ऑफ लॉर्ड शिवा. थर्ड नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इन दिस इज देयर कंस्ट्रक्शन पैटर्न. देयर कंस्ट्रक्शन पैटर्न इज ट्रेबेट मेथड ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस ट्रेबेट मेथड? सी इन इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन दे यूज बोथ मेथड्स, वन इज अ ट्रेबेट मेथड एंड अनदर वन इज कॉर्बेट आर्चेस. नाउ व्हाट आर दिस कॉर्बेलेट आर्चेस एंड ट्रिबेट मैथड? इन ट्रिबेट मैथड इट इज समथिंग रिलेटेड, और इट्स एन आर्किटेक्चरल स्टाइल इन विच देर आर बीम्स. सो बीम्स वाला जो मैथड आता है इट इज नोन एज द ट्रिबेट मैथड. वेर एज इन द कॉर्बलेट मैथड सी आर बी डबल एल ई टी कॉर्बलेट मैथड इट इज समथिंग लाइक दिस. एंड फॉर ड्रेनेज पर्पज दीज पीपल यूज दिस मैथड, एंड फॉर हाउस कंस्ट्रक्शन दीज पीपल यूज ट्रिबेट मैथड. Now in tribute method, in the construction part, the dwelling place of these people was mainly in the either single-storied houses or double-storied houses. Indus Valley civilization had a grid pattern kind of a structure in which it was something like this. Every street in Indus Valley civilization cut in a 90 degrees angle, whereas in these structures were having houses, and these houses were the outlet of these houses, or you can say the exit or entry to these houses was not in the main side, it was on the rear side. So it was something like a urban civilization where these streets were in 90 degrees. And one of the most prominent feature of this industrial civilization is drainage pattern, friends. This drainage pattern is one of the most striking feature of industrial civilization. Why it is most striking feature of Indus Valley civilization? Because Indus Valley civilization people knew the art, or you can say they knew the value of water. So first thing they did was they designed their cities in a such a fashion that the outlet of water was very much streamlined. For example, if a case take the case of Dholavira. Dholavira, when we excavated this site, Dholavira, it was something, the central structure was somewhere here. So after the excavations, we found that something was, this structure was actually like this. Now, what was the need of this structure? Initially, it was not understood what is the need of this structure. Later on, it was opined that there used to be a river over here in Dholavira. Whensoever there was flood in this river, the water used to overflow or used to break the banks of this river, and it moved into these chambers. These are the big chambers or tanks. So water moved into these chambers, and after moving into these chambers, water again was diverted to this place. And this water which was over there in these tanks, this water was used during the dry seasons. So somewhere, friends, these people knew the art of directing water and using it in a very channelized way. So this part was the Dholavira. ओके, नाउ धौलावीरा को अगर हम देखते हैं, इनके अगर हम पैटर्न्स को देखते हैं, सो समवेयर वी कैन कंक्लूड दैट इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन पीपल वर वेरी गुड एट डायरेक्टिंग द वाटर्स. दे हैव ऑल्सो सी एज आई एम सेइंग दैट इट्स अ पार्ट ऑफ अ प्रोटो हिस्टोरिक फेज, इट डजेंट मीन दैट दे हैव रिटन एनीथिंग. दे हैव एंड दे हैव रिटन इट इन देयर ओन द स्क्रिप्ट. द नेम ऑफ द स्क्रिप्ट विच हैज बीन गिवन टू देम इज बोस्त्रोफेदन, बी ए USTROPHADEN, बोस्त्रोफेदन. So Bostrophedon is the name of the script which has been given to Indus Valley civilization people. तो अगर हम इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन का इफ आई कंक्लूड इट टू कंक्लूड द इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन आई वुड से दैट दीज पीपल न्यू द आर्ट ऑफ मेटलर्जी. मेटलर्जी ये सारे के सारे लोग जानते थे कैसी होती है. दीज पीपल न्यू द आर्ट ऑफ ड्रेनेज. दीज पीपल न्यू द आर्ट ऑफ ट्रेड. प्रेशियस स्टोन्स. फैशन. फैशन के केस में वी हैव सीन सिल्वर ऑर्नामेंट्स एंड गोल्ड ऑर्नामेंट्स. Then apart from it, these people also knew the art of sailing. We have got something, a ship model at Lothal, dockyard at Lothal. So agar inke paas dockyard bhi tha, to matlab ye ships bhi the inke paas. So this civilization was having ships. This civilization was having gold. This civilization was having bronze. This civilization was having extensive trade. This civilization was having agriculture. And this civilization was somewhere centrally administered. And architecturally, this civilization was very strong because it had storied building also. It had citadels also, where great bath and other major important things were there. So, ek said, inka architecture dekhe, कल्चर देखें, सोसाइटी देखें, लोगों को देखें, ट्रेड विद अदर सिविलाइजेशंस देखें, वी कैन कंक्लूड दैट दिस सिविलाइजेशन वाज आल्सो नॉट अ कॉमन काइंड ऑफ सिविलाइजेशन. इट वाज फर्स्ट अर्बन सिविलाइजेशन ऑन द प्लेनेट. बट अगेन देयर वाज समथिंग डिफरेंट इन द एंड आल्सो. द सिविलाइजेशन इंडस्ट्रियल सिविलाइजेशन अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस ऑल फीचर्स इट डिसअपीयर्ड फ्रॉम द पेजेस ऑफ हिस्ट्री. All of a sudden, it disappeared. Now, why this Indus Valley civilization disappeared from the pages of history, we have no concrete proofs. In this regard, the Indus Valley civilization people, if I talk about this, some historians opine that Indus Valley civilization was a civilization which you can say vanished due to tectonic upliftment. Ho sakta hai tectonic upliftment hui ho. So, they opined it. Some said that there was a flood in the river. That can also be accepted. Due to flood, these people migrated to the higher regions. Some people said that there could be a catastrophic like a disease and all. So that can also be accepted. But one of the strongest reasons for the disappearance of these Indus Valley civilization people comes from the fact that Rigveda, when we study this Ved, we come across that they say that they have destroyed one city and the name of the city is Hariupia, which is considered as Harappa civilization. So Indus Valley civilization, concludingly, it was disappeared from the pages of the history, according to history, is due to Aryans. From this phase, the next phase started of our Indian history, that is Aryans or Aryanization. And with this Aryanization, we enter into the historic phase of India. Yahan se hum historic phase mein enter karte hain. That I'll be talking about this Aryanization in my next lecture, friends. Till that time, keep studying. Thank you.